In this video, we are going to talk about Moon conjunct Mercury, the best ascendants and the effect of this conjunction and more. So keep watching. Namaste and welcome to Pramanik Astrology Channel. I'm your host Prasad Mahajani. Before we start into this Moon and Mercury conjunction, I want to tell you one thing. I'm conducting a free live training for more than 3 hours on 15th of January 2022, 11 a.m. Indian Standard Time, wherein I will take you from the basics of astrology to the advanced astrology so that you will be able to make concrete predictions even if you have no prior background to Vedic astrology. And you can read birth charts and you will be able to make predictions and, you know, learn Vedic astrology step by step. Okay, you have to just register yourself for that event into the following link. Just reserve your spot and you will get an email to, you know, how you can connect on that day, right? So now we are going to deep dive into the basics of astrology, which will help you to get started into Vedic astrology, even if you have no prior background to Vedic astrology. I'm waiting for you there. Click on the link below and just reserve your spot for this free live training. Moon and Mercury conjunction. Moon and Mercury are father and son. Okay, there are two father and son combinations. One is Sun and Saturn and the other one is Moon and Mercury. So these two planets are not comfortable with each other in certain places, in certain Rashis. But if you look at the significations of Moon and Mercury, you will be able to understand more about that person. Let's talk about that. What is Moon? I have already made a separate video on what is Moon. Moon is about your emotions, mind, desires and privacy and feelings and all that is Cancerian and motherly. Okay, and what is Mercury? Mercury is the celestial prince. Sun is the king, Moon is the queen and Mercury is the prince. So he always likes to connect with people. He likes to be involved into the leisure activities. He likes to communicate with people. He like people. He like networking. He like friendships. Okay, that's how Mercury is. We all know that. But there are few other qualities of Mercury we will discuss and deep dive into this video. Let's talk about the conjunction of Moon and Mercury. Moon is the planet of your mind. The planet of mind conjuncts with your planet of intellect. So this makes these people extremely intelligent. These people can be genius. You know, they are always involved into all the intellectual abilities, into the all intellectual activities, because their mind is now connected with the intellect. So they always want to, you know, working with mathematics, accounting or problem solving, you know, all kinds of things, analyzing the information, processing the information, organizing it and, you know, bringing out the conclusion from different patterns and signs. That's the strength of the Mercury. Now it is connected with mind, so this person is always involved into these kind of activities. Moon is the planet of feelings and your inner feelings, and sometimes it is also about your intuition. Now the planet of feelings and intuition is conjunct with the planet of intellect and intelligence. So these people have great intuitive abilities. Their intuitive abilities get sharpened due to the association of Mercury with this Moon. Okay, let's say you only have Moon with some other planetary alignments. It won't have that sharp and cutting edge to see through things and to, you know, experience it at intellectual level. You can feel it but won't be able to express it. This expression comes through the Mercury, because communication is the key and the most important characteristic of Mercury. So these people can now feel with their intuitive nature and now will be able to communicate these things with other people. Okay, this is a very good combination for intuitive people. Mercury is the planet of communication. the planet of communication conjuncts with the planet which is all about your mind. So these people always want to be connected with, you know, some sort of Mercurian activities like writing or, you know, public speaking or, you know, speaking to the larger audience, maybe through writing the blogs or maybe YouTube or maybe podcast. But some way or the other, they want to connect with the other people and want to speak with larger audience. That's what these guys do. Okay, and they are great at connecting with people, communicating with people, because they have this unique knack of communicating with the larger audience. Communicating with one-on-one is a different story, but when you speak to the audience, you have different context, you have different references, you have altogether different vision as to what you want to portray or what you want to convey to the audience. Who is listening to me? These people have a great sense of who is listening to who is their audience, and they can change accordingly. So they have great abilities to become the public speaker because they have that versatile nature, and at the same time they have the ability to communicate. Okay, Moon is the planet of fluctuation. Do you see that? Moon is always fluctuating from new moon to the full moon, from the full moon to the new moon, right? That's what tithis are. So moon is always fluctuating. The planet of fluctuation conjuncts with the planet of duality. Mercury is neither masculine nor feminine. Mercury has balanced views. Okay, so Mars is masculine, Venus is feminine, but Mercury is the planet which is balanced, right? Now the planet of fluctuation conjuncts with the duality. So these people have, you know, always changing moods. These people have, these people are, you know, always fluctuating or changing their pursuits, or, you know, they start the project but suddenly they get attracted to something else and they start working on that project, right? So this is one drawback with Moon and Mercury. If these people can focus on one thing, which is very difficult for them, but let's say if they manage to focus on this limited or only one thing at a time, they can have brilliant outcome when it comes to the intellectual activities or any kind of activities involving the communication or the larger people. Moon and Mercury are not comfortable being with each other. You might think that, oh, Mercury is also intellect and Moon is also mind, so they will get along well. But unfortunately, they don't get along well. But when they are conjunct, we always have to see the dignity. When we are judging this conjunction, we have to judge this through the dignity, ascendant, lordships, and the placement itself. The sign of Mercury and Moon are adjacent. Like the sign of Mercury is Gemini, and the next sign is the Cancer sign, the fourth sign, right? So the best ascendant would be when Mercury is ruling the ninth house and Moon is ruling the 10th house. So it comes into the sign of Libra. When you have Libra ascendant or you have Aquarius ascendant, these people tend to get great result. Okay, so the best ascendant for this conjunction is Libra or Aquarius, or, you know, when they are connected with the Kendra and the trine. Okay, and the best placement for this conjunction is in Lagna, the 10th house, or into the 3rd house as well. Okay, so yes, this was Moon and Mercury as much as I could hold grasp and share with you guys. If you want to learn Vedic astrology step by step, join me on live free training on 15th of January. Check out the link into the description section or my website, and you will reserve your spot, and we will deep dive into the reading of the birth chart, from the basics of birth chart to the advanced. sending you tons of positive energy, sending you high vibrations. See you in the next videos. Love and peace. Namaste. See you on the training.